Hello people. Today I'll be talking about Fargate, the new serverless container solution from AWS. Fargate was announced at reInvent 2017 and built on top of ECS by introducing a new deployment method. With what is now officially known as EC2 ECS, you would start with an EC2 instance that you install Docker and the ECS agent on. And obviously you're not limited to a single instance either. Once you have this one or multiple instances, you then use ECS tasks to deploy your containers on them. Now, what Fargate does is it makes this part of it all disappear so that you're just left with the containers themselves. As you still need to be able to reach your containers, an Elastic Network interface is added. Let's see how this works in practice by going through the new quick start. As you can see, this will set up a new Fargate container for us, where I will just use the sample app and I'm not changing any of the defaults for it. Next, we can select whether we want to put an LB in front of this, which I don't want right now. And we can give our cluster a name, but you can also see that it will create a VPC and subnets for us to deploy the containers in. This is managed by a CloudFormation template and will be two public subnets. Now, a quick review and time jump later, and the cluster is created with a sample app. So let's have a look at our new application. To find the address, it's actually a bit hard and we have to go through viewing the service, looking at the task, and then clicking on the ENI, which then finally shows the IP address we need. And then we're there. One sample app, ready to go. So this was all pretty easy and quick, which is obviously meant to highlight the advantages of Fargate. Not only was it easy to set up, but we didn't have to worry about any infrastructure, which means that we don't need to manage the instances or Docker and the ECS agents running on them. In addition, the fact that it uses ECS can be an advantage if you're already used to that. It's not all wonderful, however, as having no infrastructure also means that there are things you can't do. You have less control over the containers, and ECS has its own downsides. And as always, a managed service is more expensive than running your own instances. However, with that last point, please keep in mind that you will have less ops work that you need to do, so you might have some cost savings there. Let's go through the process of creating a new Fargate service by hand to see where these limitations actually show up. For this, we start with creating a new task definition, naturally choosing the Fargate option. I'll give it a name and a default role, and you can see that the only option for the network mode is AWS VPC. Moving on, there's a limited set of options for CPU and RAM when not every combination is valid. At a minimum, you need to have twice as much RAM as CPU, and each CPU size has its own maximum amount of RAM that it supports as well. The container definition is pretty straightforward, but you can see with the port mappings that you can't assign a host port. Similarly, there's no option for mounting a volume from the host. Let's move on and create this definition. Now I'll create a new service in the cluster, and you can see that choosing Fargate makes the task placement option disappear. I'll pick the task definition that was just created, and on the next page it automatically fills in the VPC, so I'll just pick the subnets and move on to the security group. This is just a regular new or existing security group picker that you're probably familiar with. You can also see that the public IP is assigned by default. Unfortunately, it's impossible to assign an Elastic IP. We can also assign it to a load balancer, but it will need to be created first. As I didn't do that, let's just not use one. Now, let's quickly create this task. And we can finally see after a bit that it's running. Once again, I'll go through the process of finding the public IP, which really should just be shown in the task. And then we can see that Jenkins needs a password from the log files. When we created the task, it actually set up a CloudWatch logs group that it pushes everything to, so we can just look inside the task itself now to find what we need. Having looked at some of the advantages and limitations, what is Fargate actually good for? Right now, I would say it's mostly for short-lived tasks that you would like to run independently from any cluster you might already have. This can be CI/CD tasks or even something you call from Lambda functions. Also keep in mind that right now, Fargate is still very new and it's only available in the North Virginia region, so expect that its usefulness will grow in the future. The team has already promised Kubernetes integration once EKS arrives in AWS, and I'm looking forward to see where Fargate will go in the future. Thank you for watching, and I hope this was useful to you.